What's up, everyone? This is Moose, and this is the Moose Tracks episode for CTF Turbine Pro RC2, this week's UGC Highlander map. I would like to re-emphasize that the correct version of the map for this week is RC2. I will go over the primary change to this map when we get out there. But before I start, I'd like to make a quick shout-out to the other TR in UGC, that being Tyro Raid in Iron Division. They are currently undefeated. But this morning I was playing at about 5:30 in the morning on I want to think it was Gold Rush, because I couldn't sleep. And I start talking to this guy named Neff. Well, Neff says, well, there's another TR tag in the server. I was like, oh, cool. I was like, what class do you main? And he starts talking about his team. He's like, well, you know, there are too many mooses in competitive now. I know you play soldier for your TR. And I'm like, yeah, that's right. He's like, I figure he's going to start talking about Dabes. Well, he's like, well, there's the XTV moose, there's the moose that does hindsight, and there's the moose that does moose tracks. I'm like, dude, I'm the same moose all three of those. He's like, whoa, that's cool. A bit of a tired rant, but I just like to give Neff and the rest of his team a quick shout out, just for appreciating what I do. Here's to hoping that you guys continue succeeding throughout the rest of the season. But anyways, okay, so here is mid of Turbine, and the biggest change is the ceiling height. If you watched Hindsight, you already know that Hindsight pointed out the ceiling is quite a bit taller. The ceiling probably only used to be to about that line right there, maybe the gray line, I don't remember. But I guess that was just to give soldiers and demo men just a little bit more space to jump. Otherwise, I'm not sure whether this is an upgrade or not from RC1, but there are boxes over here leading up to the banana, and we'll talk about this feature of the map in a little bit. But I think those are the two biggest changes to this map. Otherwise, it's the same turbine you all know and love. Maybe I say love with a little bit of apprehension. But, let's talk about Turbine a little bit. Now, Hein pointed out in the forums, and I think this is a very eloquent way of putting it, that Turbine is unique in the fact that if both teams push out at the same time, it's one of the few maps where you have no choice other than to fight each other pretty much right off the bat. 5CP maps, it usually takes about, what, 30 seconds to get out to mid and start fighting. Maybe scouts and demo men get out a little bit faster. But here, Turbine, it's really just a 5-6 second rollout, and you're right here in the middle, and you guys start fighting. So it can be a very quickly fast action, fast-paced mid-fight. And Turbine, the midpoint is probably the most important point, because this will be your staging area for the cap. Now, we'll go into strategies for that in just a little bit, but I'd like to go over some of the routes to the cap. You really have four ways, maybe. First way is through the banana. Some people call this macaroni or elbow or hallway, just whatever they want to call it. This is obviously characterized by this U-shaped structure, J-shaped structure, and then a sliding door, which leads out to a platform. Now this platform has a health pack on it. You jump down, and there's the enemy intel. Now in this room, you have a small health pack, medium-sized ammo pack, and that is really about it. Obviously the point of CTF is to go in there, grab the intel, and run back out. Take it back to your intel room, which is mirrored on both sides, and that's how you score points. Now with UGC, as of right now, halftime is at 20 minutes or the first team to 7 caps. Whichever comes first. So if you manage to cap it 7 times in like 15 minutes, it's automatically going to force a half. If you only cap it 4 times and 20 minutes goes up, then halftime will force itself. Now, the other way is through this choke. This is often called choke, or main, depending on how you want to look at it. This is probably one of the most direct routes in. You come in through here, through the Z, and you push through these same two doors in. Now, the other two routes are not as commonly used for main pushes, the first one being through the vents. Now you can come up here up top, push through these vents, and run past their spawn area. This is the hallway up to spawn. Push through here, come out, continue through the vent, and you come out here. Now you are above the intel. This is a great way for flanking and jumping classes to go, because in the case of a soldier, he could simply jump down there, grab the intel, jump right back up in the vent, and run back. Now, obviously, his team's going to need to support him, because the first thing that the red team is going to do here is say, okay, the soldiers come back through the vents. They're going to see you right here. They're going to be like, nope, you ain't going any farther than that. So there has to be a little bit of coordination with your team if you want to use that route, and that's why it's one of the less used routes. Now, the final way is through their spawn hallway. This is over on the right for both sides. It's got this little sliding garage door. You go up the stairs. Now both teams spawn right here in this glassed off area, so if you want to run through here, you have to run right by their spawn, you have to run right by their health packs, and that makes them stronger and more able to hold this area than you. And that's why it's not, you'll rarely ever see that used effectively now. The only time you'll ever see people holding in here on the enemy side, a blue player holding in the red hallway here, is if red got wiped. And they're going to go for a spawn camp, so their scout and their spy can just do a quick chain cap two or three times before they have to fall off. Now, as far as strategy goes, you really have one option, and that is to hold mid. Usually the team that holds mid the longest is the one that's got the strongest forward on offensive presence, and that is useful. Because you need a strong offensive presence to cap the point. Now, what you're usually going to do is all your team's going to run right out through here, through the sliding door. The other team's going to get out about the same time. Now, what you really want to do is you want to force them out. So the demo man's going to have to get aggressive. He could sit here and charge stickies right through this area, probably angle them up about this high, and they'll land right here, and you can put a sticky trap right outside their door if your demo man jumps out. And keep them from getting too aggressive out here. You can send a soldier up onto this crate. He can jump up here and start spamming rockets. You can send a pyro to flank this way, maybe. Usually a pyro will actually, we'll actually talk about specific class roles in just a little bit. But the main point is aggression. You want to get in a position where you can force the enemy out of any of these doors. Now that means usually you want to take their stairs. That gives you height advantage. It keeps you pretty safe from snipers, especially if you put like a heavy right here. You have your demo spamming stickies, you have your soldier up on a crate spamming them out, you have people watching all these doors, maybe your sniper up top watching. There's it's real hard to push out from that. Now once you have that forward position, now you've kind of opened up the ground to make a push. Now usually an engineer and a pyro will split off from the main combo at the very beginning and come down here, build a gun, and the pyro comes down here to thwart the scout and the spy from wrecking what the engineer built up early. Now if the engineer can't get a good gun built up real early, it could be something he struggles to keep up with for the rest of the match. So pyro usually comes down here and kills spies and kills scouts and lets the engineer get all his gear set up. Now, if you have that forward hold on mid and you manage to kill their medic or you manage to kill their heavy classes, that means you can afford to send your medic and your demo in here in front of your scout, or maybe with your scout, with your spy, have them bonk or sap the gun, and have your demo come in here, kill it, have your scout grab. You guys come back out here, hold in a good strong position, and chain cap. Now, chain caps, I say that because it's probably the fastest way to start accumulating caps. Basically what that means is that you have someone holding down their intel so that your two capping classes, which are usually your scout and your spy, that could be obviously interchanged with your soldier and your scout, whatever classes are strongest at capping on your team, they'll sit in here while someone else holds this. And as soon as your scout takes the intel in and caps, your soldier will grab it and start going, or vice versa. And if you can hold this, obviously that's the best case scenario. If you can completely lock them out of their own intel room somehow, you basically have won the match. Usually that doesn't happen. Usually the defensive team will have that resupply cabinet bonus, or advantage rather. So a team has to be a little bit more passive than that about just holding right up in their face. Usually this is a staging spot for Uber builds, especially once mid is locked down. Now usually a team will leave like a soldier and a sniper out here to lock down mid. If they're really ahead, they'll move their engineer up and just have him help lock down mid, while the rest of your heavies and your capping classes just stand here, get ready, and build Uber so they can go in for the next push. That's really basically the strategy for Turbine. There's really no trick to it. You really want to win the first mid fight. It can be really hard to come back. If you do lose the first mid fight, what you really want to do is go back here and support your engineer. If any of your heavy classes manage to make it out of the mid fight alive, but your team's obviously losing, have them run back up to the resupply and then come down here and support your engineer and your pyro from having their stuff destroyed. Once you have a good defensive hold, you can wipe a team trying to push in and then retake mid before they spawn. I think it's a 15 second respawn time. And so if you wipe them when they're trying to push in, you can easily push back out and at least take your half of mid back. Now that will set you back up in aggressive and forward position for your team to start capping, especially if you can get back in their face, get in their banana, and then start sending your scout and your spy in for caps. Couple more things of note. The intel, if you drop it, takes a whole minute to reset. Now, if I were to go take the blue, red intel, rather, and then drop it, it would take a minute for it to go back to spawn. And unlike Vitalism, which we played in summer, if you are holding theirs, they can still cap yours. That was mentioned in Hindsight, or someone asked that in the Hindsight comments, so I just thought I'd clarify that here. Otherwise, guys, there's really no trick to Turbine. It's really, the first fight is DM, the rest of it is just coordinating solid pushes. Be sure you're practicing that this week. In addition to Swiftwater next week, which coordinating pushes on a payload map could actually be some of your best practice for any other map, 5CP maps as well. But CTF is really where your coordination is really going to be put to the test. So make sure you guys are really keeping your comms clear this week and doing your thing. Now, that is really about it for me, guys. I'm tired. I'm going to go take a nap. You can probably hear it in my voice. If, as usual, I'm in the forums 24/7, more or less. So drop me a message. Leave me a comment. You can email me at moose@ugcleague.com with questions. Your contact limits are basically endless. So don't be afraid to contact me. I don't bite. And this is Turbine for everyone. Hope everyone has a really good match, and I will see you on Swiftwater next week, guys. Moose signing out.